What's up internet? Bibili ka ng motherboard and gusto mo sigurado na compatible to sa ibang components mo para hindi masayang pera mo. And this video is part of our series na para sa mga PC beginners para kumbaga may guide sila paano bumili ng iba't ibang components. And based dun sa comments sa other videos in this series, mukhang nakatulong naman. Maraming nagsasabi na natutuwa sila dun sa video series. Pero yung natuwa talaga is yung sponsor namin kasi ang daming pumunta sa site nila after nakita nila itong ad na to.
Kung naghahanap ka ng legit Windows 10 Pro CD key, may special promo ngayon ang CD key offers for Black Friday. Mura na sila dati, mas mura pa sila ngayon. And may dagdag 20% discount if you use our promo code.
Add to cart, check out, daan ka sa payment options nila, wala pa isang minuto, finished. May legit working CD key ka na sa software na pinili mo. Gamitin ang aming promo code para makakuha pa ng extra 20% discount sa purchase mo. Kung naghahanap ka ng mura, legit, and original software, check out cdkoffers.com.
So, if you're familiar with the way we do things in the series, parang may isang component, bibili ka ng motherboard, and then dadaan tayo dun sa rest of the list, dadaan tayo dun sa list of components na kailangan mong tutukan, kailangan mong siguraduhin na tugma or compatible dun sa motherboard mo. And to be honest, hinuli ko tong si motherboard kasi basically everything or 95% of the computer connects to the motherboard. So, you know, you need to check a lot of things when you're buying a motherboard. Parang reviewer na rin to. Most of the things na pag-usapan ko dito, napag-usapan ko na rin sa ibang videos. Because may expression na all roads lead to Rome. When you're building a computer, all roads lead to the motherboard. Kailangan talaga sigurado ka na compatible yung mobo mo sa specs mo. So, number one, CPU, yes, kailangan natin tutukan yan. CPU cooler, yes, we need to check that. RAM, yes, we need to check that. Storage, we need to check that. GPU, we sort of need to check that. Case, yes, we need to check that. RGB, yes, we need to check that. And yung huli na lang, PSU, actually, yun, not really. So we'll start with the CPU. Yung mahalaga dito, check mo kung same socket ba sila. Yung CPU tsaka motherboard, may iba-ibang sockets yan. And kagaya nung nabanggit ko sa dating video, the way I like to think about them is different shapes. All the shapes are physically the same, pero isipin mo na lang na iba-ibang sockets, iba-ibang shape, hindi talaga magkakasya yan. So let's say may CPU ka, socket LGA 1151. Let's say triangle yung shape ni 1151. Tapos yung motherboard mo, socket AM4. Let's say, rectangle yung shape ni AM4. So, hindi talaga tugma yung triangle dun sa rectangle. Hindi ba talaga may install yung CPU mo na 1151 socket dun sa socket AM4? It just won't work. Sayang lang pera mo. Hindi talaga yun compatible. That's why it's always very important na check mo lang kung ano ba socket ng CPU mo and anong socket ng motherboard mo. They need to be the same socket. General rule, kung same socket sila, compatible yan. So lahat ng AM4 CPUs compatible sa socket AM4 motherboards. Yung problema, there are always exceptions dun sa general rule. For instance, yung mga bagong Ryzen, may bagong motherboard si AMD, the B550. The B550 is only compatible with the Ryzen 3 series pataas. And nakakalito yon kasi Ryzen 1 and Ryzen 2 series, AM4 din naman yon. So that's an exception to the general rule na if the socket of the CPU is the same as the socket of the motherboard, then compatible silang dalawa. Nakakainis actually kasi ako personally gusto ko, simple lang dapat, diba? Kung pareho naman socket nila, then dapat compatible sila. And that is true most of the time, but you should be aware of exceptions, especially now na may bagong motherboard si AMD at sikat na sikat si Ryzen ngayon. Yung ibang concern sa motherboard and CPU, paminsan tama naman, compatible naman yung CPU, tsaka compatible naman yung motherboard, same socket naman sila. Pero problema, kailangan mo muna i-update yung BIOS ng motherboard bago ma-install mo yung bagong CPU. What's the BIOS of the motherboard? Basically, ito lang yung operating software ng motherboard. Kung sanay naman tayo sa operating software, Windows is an OS, iOS is the OS for Mac, sa cellphone may Android, may Linux or the desktop also. So basically, the OS is the operating software. It tells the computer how to run. Yung BIOS, yung OS ng mobo. Kasi paminsan, medyo luma na yung, actually like yung AM4, medyo matagal-tagal na yung socket format na yun. Paminsan magre-release sila ng mga bagong CPUs na same socket and kaya pa naman dun sa same socket motherboard. Problema, since medyo luma na si motherboard, hindi niya maintindihan paano kausapin si CPU. Bago kasi si CPU eh. Kumbaga may generation gap. Isipin mo na lang na iba na yung wika nila. I mean, it's sort of like, it can be English, but the motherboard is speaking old English, tapos yung CPU gamit niya is modern English. You know, they sound the same, but they're really not. So yung pag-update mo sa BIOS, parang tinuturuan mo si motherboard paano kausapin yung bagong CPU. So you need to check that also. Sometimes kaya naman, same tama naman yung general rule, same socket means compatible si CPU pati si motherboard, pero kailangan ng BIOS update. Yung BIOS update medyo tricky yun kasi kung namatay yung kuryente sa gitna ng pag-update mo ng BIOS, wala na, goodbye mobo na yan, na brick na yan. It's sort of like na parang gumagawa ka ng brain surgery and then sa gitna namatay yung ilaw, may natamaan yung surgeon na hindi dapat natamaan or hindi natapos yung pag-ayos doon sa loob ng brain. Pag on ng ilaw, wala na, hindi mo na matuloy yung operation. Updating the BIOS is a bit trickier. Hindi lang siya parang sa cellphone na pipindot ka lang tapos mag-update na yung OS. Hindi kagaya ng Windows na may automatic push update sa Windows 10. Pwede mo naman pagawin sa shop kung saan ka bibili. We do it for our customers here at Hardware Sugar. And you just need to ask na, oy, kailangan ba i-update yung BIOS? And if they check, they say yes. And then you can request the shop na, oy, pwede pa-update na para kayo na rin mag-install ng CPU. Medyo, yung BIOS update din kasi, you need to use a generation na kaya pang kausapin ni motherboard. Kumbaga, hindi mo kaagad masalpak yung bago mong CPU. You use that CPU to get the motherboard to run para ma-update mo yung BIOS. Pag naturuan na si motherboard or kumbaga na-install na yung bagong BIOS, dun mo lang pwede isalpak yung bagong CPU. Kaya medyo mabusisi yung pag-update ng BIOS. CPU cooler, yes, kailangan mo rin i-check yun, but it follows the same rule. Check mo lang na same socket yun. So, yung mga CPU cooler, whether AIO yan or air cooling, palaging nakalagay kung anong socket compatible. Socket LGA 1152 compatible or 115X. 5X just means na kahit anong number after 5, pwede siya. Or socket AM4, which is the most popular socket now for AMD. So, yung CPU cooler, nakalagay naman dyan anong socket yung compatible. Just make sure na yan nga yung socket nung motherboard mo, na compatible silang dalawa. So, very similar to the CPU, just make sure both sockets are compatible. GPU, yung concern lang talaga dito sa GPU is may PCIe slot ka for your graphics card. Pero actually, you know, you don't really need to think about this anymore kasi 99% of all motherboards and of all graphics cards now all use the PCIe slot. So medyo no-brainer to, wag mong problemahin masyado. And that's really all you need to know for GPUs and motherboard. Just make sure that your board has a free PCIe slot for your card and you're good to go. Storage. So may isa pa tayong video dito tungkol sa hard drive and SSD. For the basics, you just need to make sure na you have an open port available. So kung hard drive na bili mo, you need to make sure na may available SATA port pa sa motherboard mo. Kung SATA SSD, same thing. You need to make sure na may available SATA port sa motherboard mo. If you bought M.2, make sure that compatible yung M.2 format dun sa motherboard. Although there's a standard M.2 format, usually that will fit in most motherboards. But you need to make sure that your motherboard has an M.2 slot. Some motherboards, older ones, and maybe budget motherboards, walang M.2 slot. Although usually the A320s now, which is the sort of entry-level board, and actually papalitan na to ni AMD. I think the next entry-level board will be the A520. Even those usually have at least one M.2 slot. But yun, just make sure if you're buying more SSDs or hard drives, either may open na SATA port na available or may M.2 port na available. And very important, yung motherboard mo kasi, dun usually nakasama yung mga SATA cables pati yung M.2 screws. Marami kaming customers over the years na gusto nila mag-upgrade. Yung problema, wala na sa kanila yung SATA cables na nandun nga sa motherboard box pero matagal na since binili nila yung computer, hindi nila alam kung nasa na yung extra cables. Ganun din yung M.2 screws. Sobrang nakakainis yung those things are super small and they're easy to lose. On a practical level, maraming pupunta sa shop and then, sige, gusto mag-upgrade, walang problema. We have hard drives, we have SSDs. Pero may SATA cable ka ba? Dala mo ba yung M.2 screw mo? And then they're like, ah, ano yun? Saan kumahanap yun? Etc. Here at Hardware Sugar, we learned from that experience. So, nagsastock na rin kami ng M.2 screws and SATA cables. But other shops might not have. Just for your own peace of mind na din. Kasi mas maganda talaga, especially for the SATA cables na kasama sa motherboard mo, yun din nagagamit mo for your storage connecting to that motherboard. Because if you watch, pwede magtanong, our live stream show, nabanggit nga ni RJ, yung isang tech expert na paminsan, for whatever reason, paminsan yung mga SATA cables, dapat standard naman yun, pero paminsan hindi lang talaga sila gumagana, which is really annoying. The best really is if you keep your SATA cables that come with the motherboard, M.2 screws, well, those are annoying, but yun nga, dito sa Hardware Sugar, we have extra. So we can install M.2s even if the customer can't find his or her screw. Yung sa RAM naman, for the basic level, you just need to make sure na tama yung RAM para sa motherboard mo. RAM has different kinds. Basically, it's DDR plus a number. Latest ngayon, DDR5. Pero sobrang bihira pa lang nun. It's really hard to find consumer level. So, karamihan ng computers ngayon, DDR4. If your mother is DDR4, you need to have DDR4 RAM. Kung DDR3 motherboard mo, kailangan DDR3 yung RAM mo. Ganun lang kasimple. And they are physically incompatible. Yung DDR3, di mo talaga masaksak yun sa DDR4 na slot. Kahit no matter how motivated you are, hindi talaga siya papasok. So just check what RAM your motherboard uses, what RAM slots you have, and then follow accordingly. DDR4 motherboard, DDR4 RAM. People ask a lot about RAM speeds, and we have a separate video about this. Pero ulitin ko lang sa video na to na you don't need to go overboard with RAM speeds. 3,200 MHz is fine, kahit 2,800 or so, okay na rin yun. You see sometimes people na yung automatically iniisip, mas mabilis, mas maganda. So, kung 3.2, okay, di 3,600 MHz, mas maganda pa, di ba? And then, tuloy-tuloy lang yun. The faster they can get, the better. Pero yung performance gains, yung real world, yung nararamdaman mo talaga sa user, sobrang slight lang, if at all, the difference between 2.8 and 3.2, and the difference between 3.2 and 3.6. And actually, yung memory clock nung AMD, for the 3000 series at least, hindi ko pa na-check tong mga bagong 5000 series, yung pinaka maximum limit niya for RAM is 3,733 or 3,733 MHz. Kung mas mabilis yung RAM mo doon, mas bumabagal pa yung performance mo. Or instead of helping you, it actually decreases performance because the memory clock or yung tinatawag ni AMD na Infinity Fabric, lampas nung, kung yung RAM mo, lampas nung 3,733 MHz, nagka-leche-leche na yung timings. You know, it's very technical. I don't wanna get into it. Sasakit lang ulo ko. Pero bottom line, may performance hit if you get RAMs faster than 3733. So, imbis na katulong, mas nakasama pa sa'yo. So, there's really no need to go overboard na kailangan yung pinakamabilis na RAM. Talagang gagastos ako for that. There's no need to do that, really. Next is RGB. For RGB and motherboards, what's important are the headers. So, usually, sinasaksak mo yung RGB components mo into the motherboard so that you can control them via software. Kung medyo high-end brand sila, like NZXT or Corsair, yung ginagamit nila is yung internal USB port. So, you need to make sure that you have the available internal USB ports on your mobo to support the lighting that you want if you're using something like NZXT AER2 or Corsair IQ RGB products. Manufacturers naman, gamit yung mga header sa motherboard. May RGB header, which is the 12-volt 4-pin, and for ARGB, there's the 5-volt 3-pin. Kung medyo nalilito ka sa mga terms na to, I really recommend you check out this video that we did about RGB kasi doon ko pinapaliwanag lahat ng iba't-ibang klase and why they're important, ano yung kind na gusto mo, what would you want to buy. For the purposes of this video, it's just important na check mo what RGB product do you have. If you have an RGB product, then you need the 12-volt 4-pin. So you need to make sure na may ganun na header yung motherboard mo. Pero kung nakabili ka ng ARGB products, you need to make sure that your motherboard has 5-volt 3-pin ARGB header. Mas madalas na one motherboard will have both headers. Hindi kagaya nung dati na usually may isang header lang yun, whether RGB or ARGB. Currently, you can find a lot of motherboards that have both kinds of headers. And sobrang nakakatulong to for builders, especially for us dito sa shop, kasi sakit talaga sa ulo dati. You know, gumagawa kami ng rig, then we would advise the customer na, oh, ito, gamitin natin itong motherboard na to. Tapos sabihin ni customer, ah, gusto ko itong ilaw na to. Let's say yung CF120 na deep cool. Tapos, check namin, yun, ARGB yun, pero yung mobo na napili namin, RGB header lang, walang ARGB header. So, hindi makontrol yung lighting using the motherboard software. Sobrang sakit sa ulo. So, I really appreciate now that more and more motherboards, nandun na yung dalawang headers na yun. Yung ARGB or yung RGB header. Para sa casing naman, kailangan mo i-check kung tugma ba yung size ng motherboard tsaka nung case mo. There are four basic sizes ng motherboards from smallest to largest, yung ITX, MATX, ATX, and EATX. And the sizing of the cases follows the sizing of the motherboards. So makahanap ka ng MATX case or ATX case. And the bigger can fit the smaller. So kung may ATX case ka, kasha doon yung ITX case, and then yung MATX, and yung ATX. So just make sure that your motherboard can physically fit into your case. So punta naman tayo sa PSU, and actually, you don't need to worry too much about the PSU. Standard na yung 24-pin na saksakan sa motherboard. Most standard PSUs now have that. One question we do get somewhat often is na yung motherboard ko may 8 plus 4 connector para sa CPU. Pero yung PSU ko may 8-pin lang para sa CPU. Okay lang ba yun? Yes, you can plug in the 8-pin dun sa 8 plus 4 connector sa motherboard. Yung natitirang plus 4 is, kumbaga dapat 12, nagamit mo lang yung 8. So yung naiwan na 4, that's just really for extreme overclocking. And for most builds, you don't need to worry about that. So that's just the basic. So we do get that question a lot, but you know, you don't really need to worry about it too much because chances are high na compatible yung motherboard mo tsaka PSU mo. So we won't discuss that dito sa basic PC series video. And that's it. Those are the basic components of the computer and tally na natin ano yung kailangan mo i-check, ano yung mga kailangan mong tutukan. And just like what we do also sa other videos in this series, magdagdag lang ako ng konting information. Number one is, what kind of specs do you want to find in a motherboard? And if you listen to, or if you read a lot of the tech forums, or you watch a lot of YouTube tukol sa mga computer hardware, usually binabanggit for motherboards is yung VRM, or yung voltage regulator module. Yung VRM actually isn't one part, but it's a combination of three parts, the MOSFET, the capacitors, and the chokes. What all of those three do basically is na, one of the main challenges of the motherboard is na siya nagdi-distribute ng kuryente sa iba't ibang parts ng computer mo. So yung gusto mo, parang a quality motherboard will regulate how much electricity is flowing through the different parts. Kasi lahat nakasaksak dyan sa motherboard, the mobo really has a lot to say in all of the timings and all of the electricity passing through the different components. Basically yung VRM, yung ginagawa niya, sinisigurado niya na malinis yung kuryente na pumapasok, meaning hindi siya spiky. Kumbaga, very steady yung current na pumapasok dun sa iba't ibang components, and tama yung amount of watts na pumapasok sa component na yun. So a lot of the technical people, they talk about VRM, kasi umiinit yung VRM as electricity passes through it. And is it stable? You know, especially if you're into overclocking, you look at the quality of the VRMs. So if you want to research on your motherboard before buying, ito usually tinitingnan ng mga experts kung maganda ba yung VRM design ng motherboard. Is there active cooling? Is there passive cooling? Actually, some videos even suggest just on a very counting the number of chokes, yung mga black na boxes doon sa motherboard. The more chokes implies na mas quality yung motherboard. Yung nga, beginner video to, so I don't wanna get into the super technicals, but if you want to look for a quality board, check out what the reviews say about the VRM of that board. Number two, do you really need an expensive motherboard? I mean, may ibang motherboards na 5,000, 6,000, and those are very good, decent boards. Pero pag check mo ng prices, may mga 15,000, 18,000, Godlike, Zenith, Extreme, yung mga tipong ganun. And kailangan mo pa talaga yung mga sobrang mahal na motherboards na yan. And for me, the answer is no. If you look at those really expensive motherboards, yes, they have a lot of different features, pero as a average consumer dun sa PC, hindi mo talaga magagamit yun. Like yung iba pang extreme overclocking, so nandun yung mga may readouts na dun sa motherboard to help the overclocker para hindi na siya papasok sa BIOS. Yes, that's helpful if you're an extreme overclocker. Paminsan may kasamang network interface card, may additional M.2 na expansion card. So there are a lot of features of these super expensive motherboards na hindi mo talaga gagamitin. And may type of PC consumer talaga na gusto lang niya yung pinakamahal. So titingin siya sa price list and then makita niya, ah, ito yung pinakamahal, ito gusto ko. Itong CPU, pinakamahal, check, akin yan. Motherboard, pinakamahal, yes, check, akin yan. And if you're that kind of consumer, more power to you, please pumunta ka sa shop namin, Hardware Sugar. Pero Sa totoo lang, for the average PC consumer, a lot of the high-end motherboards have things you don't really need. And you can get very decent motherboards for a very good price. In fact, yung mga B550, compare mo sa B450, to be honest, hindi naman ganun kalayo yung performance nila eh. I think the B550 has PCIe 4, the B450s don't. But if you're not gonna use PCIe 4, let's say yung GPU mo PCIe 3 lang, then the B450 is fine. So you can really find good motherboards at a very decent price. And syempre, mga manufacturers gusto nila bili ka palagi. So it's in their interest na maglalabas sila nung iba't ibang motherboards na yes, may mga features naman sila, pero yun nga, gagamitin mo ba talaga yun? So you can save quite a lot by just getting the motherboard that you need and wag ka mawili na, uy, itong si ano, yung kaibigan ko may Maximus, kailangan ako din Maximus, or kailangan ako din naka-godlike or whatever. And if they really need those features, good for them, but as an average PC consumer, you probably will not need them. And lastly, number three, medyo overlooked siya for motherboards, pero if you're a builder, you need to keep it in mind, yung aesthetics. Yung motherboard kasi, yan talaga nakikita mo. Yes, natatakpan siya ng GPU, natatakpan siya ng CPU cooler, yung RAM nakasaksak dyan. Pero inevitably, kahit gaano ka cramped yung case mo, kahit gaano ka laki yung mga components mo, kita pa rin yung motherboard. So if you care about aesthetics for the build, you do want to try to select motherboards that, kumbaga parang painting yan eh. Yung motherboard, canvas mo yan. Tapos, dun ka magdadagdag. So if you want an all-white build, actually mahirap ngayon makahanap ng maganda na all-white motherboards. The last I remember was like really old, MSI B360 Arctic, pero B360 pa yun. You do have a lot of gray motherboards now. From ASRock, for example, yung Steel Legend, maganda. Actually, yung hindi siya white, pero yung maganda na motherboard just aesthetically is yung ASRock the Tai Chi. And that's a really nice looking board. We do have it on stock here sa Hardware Sugar. Medyo may pagka steampunk yung dating. A lot of viewers will think, so what? Aesthetics lang yan. But aesthetics matter, especially for yung nagbe-build talaga. Kaya nga lahat ng mga cases ngayon, yung isang side, palaging transparent yan so that you can see inside your case. And kung hindi maganda yung motherboard or kung hindi jive, hindi tugma dun sa ibang pieces, parang nakakahinayang i-display. So aside from performance and aside from specs, nakakadagdag din yung motherboard sa aesthetics ng case. Usually, marami ngayon naka all black na motherboard, tapos maganda na yung mga heatsinks, parang naka-cover na lahat. They like calling it naka-armor yung motherboard and things like that. So marami iba-ibang looks depending sa style mo. Yun, personally, if I were going to build for myself, I really would look into the Tai Chi. I think that's a really nice looking motherboard with good features also. Aesthetics is up to the user, so kung gusto mo may RGB yung motherboard, pwede din, you can choose that. I've seen some Aorus motherboards and things like that. So don't forget aesthetics also when choosing the motherboard. So actually, this is it. Dumating na tayo sa huling basic part ng computer, dumana na tayo sa buong list. And yung una kong plano, hihinto na ako dito. Since every part may video na, ito na sana yung conclusion nung series na to. Pero, you know, I read the comments and a lot of people have been asking paano pumili ng monitor, or nagtatanong sila kung magkakaroon ba ng video for bibili ka ba ng UPS or AVR. And thanks to popular demand, dadagdag tayo ng dalawa pang video. Number one, bibili ka ba ng UPS or AVR? What do you need to know? And number two, bibili ka ng monitor? What do you need to know? So, di pa tapos yung series, pero tapos na tong motherboard video. Thanks for watching!